Apparently, I'm one of the delicate children. Who knew? I didn't. My mother did not either. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video where I'm going to compare. That was the word I was looking for. It's difficult, apparently. The classical paradise, the old one versus the new one from Ace Beauté. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love makeup just as much as I do, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, if you just want to have plain old fun, and if you are slightly orcish, like me, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are still having a blast in our post-Halloweeny band, now dubbed Nightmare Before Christmas. Let me explain the slightly orcish. It means olive. I'm a warm, delicate olive. And sometimes shadows warp on me, or colors warp on me. Now, I have used the Natasha Denona base today. It is the base that I'm using right now. I have the shade medium, which turns on me a little bit almost orangey. Peach. Is it peachy? I always say peachy, but it's not. It actually kind of turns a little bit to the shade rye that is in this palette. Let me show them to you side by side, because they reformulated. Also, the packaging is a little bit different, because the original Classical Paradise is thinner in. So the new one is basically twice the thickness, almost. Yes, the shades are largely the same. Some shades do have differences though. So let me also show you the swatches. And on the top row is the original, and on the bottom is the new one. What I noticed actually was that, where are we? The shade rye, which is the lightest one, it oxidized on me, which is kind of weird. So here you can see that lighter part in the center, it is basically built up there, and there it doesn't oxidize, which is kind of weird because my arm is clean, it's dry, there's nothing going on there except the fact that it oxidizes. And I can see it with the newer one, it just deepens up. For the rest, all the shadows look very, very similar. With the exception again of this one, which is the shade Soil. In the original palette, it is way darker. And in this palette, it is almost the same color as the color Clay. Can you see that when I swatch it? And then for the rest, everything is largely the same. The shade Barley has a hint different, because in the original one it is more of a, I don't know, it has more of an orangey in it, and in the newer one it is almost more like a yellowy in it. Can you see that? I hope you can. What I noticed when I swatched them is that the original palette swatched feels very dry, especially the darker shades, and I have noticed that from the beginning. So especially the darker shades felt very, very dry. And one of my favorite shades, which is, can you guess, the olivey green, when which is called Golden Apple, it, in the old palette, it felt, I don't know, now it, this one feels way better, let's just say that. So I kind of was thinking about what I want to do, because I want to do one eye, one palette, and the other eye, the other palette, so we can really see the comparison, because now I have just swatched it, and swatches don't say anything I want to say, but not everything. I think I am going to go here, so to the darker shades, because I really want to see how those behave. Now, I also remember very, very much that when I started playing with this palette, I was like, ooh, it's very, very pigmented. So I kind of hope that the newer one is a little bit less. I am going to do the old one on this eye and the new one on that eye. Fun fact is that usually when I played with this palette, I played with the oranges and the greens. But that's okay. I'm going to start with the shade Rye. And I am going to grab somewhat of a, I don't know, bigger, fluffier brush, shall we? Do I have two of you? Yeah, kinda. Okay, I'm going to start with the shade Rye, which is the lightest shade, with a big fluffy brush. Now, on the original one, I pick up a lot. So let's zoom you guys in as well. Oh, hello! Ooh, close and personal. Let me go to the downside and fix my lighting. That's a bit better. Okay, let's kind of tap this on as a transition shade. I don't know if you will see a lot, but that's okay. Okay, so what I noticed right away is that the newer palette has less kick up. Now, I don't mind kick-up at all. I actually like a little bit of kick-up, so it has a hint of kick-up, but not a lot. I think I'm one of the few who likes a little bit of kick-up, because I kind of feel like I don't have to dig my brush in as much. It's not always the case though, but what can I say? That's me. Okay, that is down. Now we're going to go to the next shade, which is going to be the shade called Clay. Okay, tap off the brush. I'm going to look down. I'm going to use this a little bit higher, but I still kind of want it light. Yes, I hope so. I'm going to lightly blend out the edge. I do remember distinctly, I haven't worked with this palette in a while, but I do remember distinctly that I prefer working on a base that was slightly set, at least where I wanted to blend. And I also noticed that some of the colors could get patchy on me. Well, not patchy, but muddy on me very quickly. Grabbing a tiny bit of clay just to make sure that I have my line. That I want to stay under, basically, or above. Okay, that's one side, yes. Let's do the same on the other eye. And I am using this. Okay, so this has a little bit of a little bit more kick up than the previous shade, which is fine. I am using the same brushes for both eyes. Okay, it feels a little bit less pigmented right off the bat, which I don't really hate, honestly. I did not really have a lot of issues with their first formula. It was just very, very pigmented, and I came from shadows that were not. So, you know, it is also a different color looking at it. This looks a little bit more blue, and this looks a little bit more, I almost want to say neutral. There's a little bit more yellow in it. So let's build it up a tiny bit. Okay, I'm going to go back to the first brush and a little bit of the shade Rye for both eyes. It's going to go over everything. Where is the other one here? I kind of feel like this one wants to blend away while this one just blends. Does that make sense? I don't know. Let's go next to the shade Soil, which is then a shade darker. Or at least it should be. Let's go with this one. I am tapping off and then I'm looking down. This is going to go a little bit lower in the crease. Now, the only thing that I kind of wish, honestly, for both palettes was that the shade Soil was the color of, I don't want to say of soil because all the soils are different, but a little bit more brown. It does give a hint of depth, but I feel like it doesn't, I don't know, I kind of feel like it doesn't need to be in the palette. And I felt that always with the first palette as well, and I kind of feel it with this one as well. I would have loved just I don't know, a deep dark brown in here, especially to combine with the shade Mineral. I'm going to go in a little bit more slowly. This one, as I said, it's a little bit less pigmented right off the bat. So if you want very, very vibrant looks, you kind of have to build it up. But I do feel that this is more beginner friendly. It scared the shit out of me when I started working with it. Going to go back to that very, very fluffy brush with nothing on. I'm just going to go over both layers, but a little bit higher. Okay. Then I'm going to go to the shade Earth. And the reason why I would like a very deep dark brown in here is because when I use the shade Golden Apple, the green, and I want to darken it up, I can darken it up with this, but it is just a little bit too red then still. It works, but it can turn a little bit muddy, and that is kind of what I Yeah, that's what I was missing in this palette. Okay. Let's go to the other one. The brush looks different. It's a similar shape though. The other one that I have from the same set is very much dirty. Okay, those are the darker shades. I don't know, let's for funsies go to the orange because I can. Let's get a brush. Let's get you, it does not really matter. I'm going to go to the shade Vegetation, which is the orange. And then I'm cleaning this brush because I only have one. So I'm cleaning it on a microfiber towel that I have here. And I'm going to go to the other palette. And it is already set underneath my eye. No eyeshadow primer. Then, because we can, I'm going to go to the shade Golden Apple. Same brush, I just cleaned it. I should not mix. I'm not mixing, I'm actually tapping it over. Then I'm going to go to the shade Maze. I'm kind of going to use the yellow to mix the two shades together a bit here. Or something, I don't know. Oh no, no, I need to go to the correct maze. Yes. What are they doing, you ask? I have no idea. It's time for the shimmers. I know I want to use the yellow called Sunflower in the inner corner, so let's start with that. Just on top of the yellow that I put down. And apparently on top of the green, because that's the way that my brush went. It looks like the new palette is more sparkly, but it also has kind of a harder time sticking to the brush that I'm using. Okay, do I also have an orangey shimmer? Yeah, we have the shade Harvest. So let's go to the shade Harvest. Still using the same brushes. No, we're going to go to the shade Hay. It's going to go here. It's dry. Not too shabby. Okay. Shade Harvest. Yes, okay, now I'm going to go to shimmer brushes. But I don't really have two of the same shimmer brushes, so that's kind of sad. I do have two that are equally crappy, so let's... Oh, I have two of the same. These are not my usual shimmer brushes, let's just say that, but they are the same, so we can kind of compare. I'm going to go to the shade Mineral. Okay, from the old palette it picks up very nicely dry. So let's see if it wants to deposit. It does. And it's still dry. Very pretty. Okay, a lot more shiny. And it almost looks like the old... I don't know, like I almost want to say like the old palette has more brown, but I don't think that it is true. It has more shine, but it's very pretty though. Okay, I'm going to clean the brush. I'm going to go then to the shade Harvest a little to blend it here. And then to the shade Earth for both eyes. Just in the outer corner and a little bit in the crease. Okay, and then we have one shimmer left, so let's grab two smaller brushes and use the last shimmer, which is the shade Barley. This one is a little bit on the new palette. It feels a little bit less dusty, I want to say. The formula, not the shade, but the formula. I finished off the look with falsies from Babydoll in style 723. Lippy is from Propa Beauty in the style Made It. And I also used the shade Ectoplasm liner from Lethal Cosmetics in my waterline. And then the fancy liner and the hint of sparkle just above my lower lashes is from Essence. It is one of their duochrome liquid eyeshadows in the shade Chromatic. I thought it would complement it very, very well. And yeah, I think that's the most important thing, right? So what is the main difference between the original and the newer one? First off, when I felt the shades, I could feel the shades in the newer one were less dry. That is what I noticed in the original ever since I got it. Some of the shades were extremely dry. kick up, there is a difference. The original has a lot of kick up. The newer one has a slight amount of kick up, which I like. And the pigmentation. The original one is instant in your face pigmentation, which is not what I go for. It's not really how I like to do my eyeshadow. So I really, really like the newer formula. Now, it's kind of mute, right? If you want something that has a very instant in your face pigmentation, you cannot get the older ones anymore. So now it's kind of a question, if you are new to Ace Beauté, will you like the new formula? If you like pigmentation but also want to build it up, yes. If you like blendability, yes, you can layer. I think that the new formulation will appeal to a heap load of people because it is just a little bit easier to control. It's easier to work with. If you want pigmentation, this was basically this eye was instant and blended out, and this eye was, I placed it and I built it up twice. This was one dip, this was two dips. Does that make any sense at all? So this for me is how I prefer it, because I am not a pack on blend out type of person. I don't do my eyeshadow that way, so I like this. I like control. I like to be able to build up my eyeshadow instead of having to really, really blend, because I am 45. My eyelids don't like it if they are moved like that for 5 minutes or longer. So I prefer that. The shimmers are stunning. I could see a difference in texture and in vibrancy a little bit in the old one versus the new one. I feel that some of the shades of the older one, especially the shade, let me see. Yeah, especially the two lighter mattes, actually, the Barley and the Sunflower, they almost felt a little bit, I want to say dusty. I also kind of want to say lackluster, because that's how they felt for me. The newer ones are more vibrant. They are a little bit more creamy, so I did see that the older formula picked up on the brush that I was using a little bit more than the newer formula. So the newer formula I had to kind of layer a little bit extra, but both sides are dry. They are not sprayed, they are not on top of a glitter primer. So basically, the only negative thing that I have to say about both color stories, which is basically the same, is that I feel, let me grab the new one, that the shade Clay and the shade Soil, they are too similar for what I go for. Yes, I could get depth, but I wish that one or the other was kind of this depth, but then with a brown and not a red. Because if I want to deepen up my green, I go towards this one, but I don't need, yeah, it kind of works, but barely. So I would have loved to have, I don't know, yeah, just a darker brown or even a darker green matte, so that I can really deepen up the shadows. I can get it through to pan, which is nice and vibrant, but still, that would have made it perfection. Now is the question, if you have the old palette, do you need the new palette? I will say only if you don't like the formula of the old palette. If you are like me and you were like, it's way too pigmented, I have to go in slow and I want to be able to control it a little bit better, then I say, sure, go for the newer one. But it's whatever you want. Now the new palette, the Tropical Paradise, no, it's the Tropics palette. The newer one, that's on its way to me as well. So you will see that when it gets here. I will do a video on that as well, because that one, oh my lord, I am so excited to play with that. But I think that was basically it. So in a nutshell, if you have the old one, do you need a new formula? No. Unless you hate the old formula, then I say go for it. If you were like, I don't really know if I will like the new formula, I hope that my review was helpful. Again, the shadows are pigmented, but they are still buildable. You can still control them if you are lighter like me. If you are deeper than me, maybe you have to build it up a little bit more than with the original formula, but I still think that you will love the new formula. That is me. I hope it was helpful. I'm feeling very, very fancy. Fancy enough to clean up my closet. Because that's what I'm going to do today. That was on the agenda. So wish me luck. And yes, this was it, guys, for today. Let me know your thoughts down below. Yeah, leave me a comment. Leave me an emoji. Leave me any emoji that you want. Leave me an olive. If you would like that. Or still spooky Halloween-y. Because my nails are still kind of in Halloween-y mode. Well, witchy mode. Because these are basically like... I am very much wanting to be Halloween-y all year round. But... technically, I'm not really allowed to anymore because Halloween is over. But I still want to be spooky. Never mind, you do you. This was it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know down below your thoughts. Did it help? Did it not help? Let me know. And then I'm going to wish you a fantastic day. Oh yeah, also don't forget to give the video a thumbs up before you go. Because it helps me out tremendously. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day. A fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.